Unit 3, Introduction. First, let us see the content of Unit 3. Unit 3 contains capacitance and inductance transducer related topics. Under capacitance transducer, we will see the principle of operation first. Then we will see some of the applications which are mentioned in the course of capacitance transducer. That is proximity sensor made with this principle. Hygrometer made with this principle. Is it clear to everybody?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now come to the second part of Unit 3. It is inductive transducer related content. First, we will see the principle of operation of inductive transducer. Then we will go into the applications of transducer made with this principle. So here also we will see three principles. Three applications. Proximity sensor also we will see, because it is not mentioned. If time permits, I will show you this thing, right? But these two are mentioned. Okay. Application which are mentioned in syllabus under inductive transducer category is, first one, LVDT, stand for linear variable differential transformer. Second one, RVDT. R stand for rotatory variable differential transducer. So both principle of operation is same, both working is also same, except here this is used for linear applications and this is used for rotary or angular application. Is it clear? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Then we will see proximity sensor made with this principle. So this is the brief content of Unit 3. Unit 3 is short. We can quickly finish this off this in 2 or 3 possible classes, right? So I'm trying my level best to complete the big part of Unit 3 today's class. Okay. Are you ready for that? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. That is nothing but principle of operation. It may come under long answer, right? So before going into this particular question, I would like to give a few silent features of this transducer. The first one is its application. Mostly, capacitive transducer is used for displacement measurement. Correct? I repeat, capacitance transducer is used for displacement measurement. The second silent feature of this type of transducer is it is non-contact type. Okay. Anybody having any idea about non-contact type mean? What is the meaning of non-contact type? It's very easy. No need to worry. See.
Automatic.
No. Not that one. See, what is the function of sensor to sense the parameter? Right? Like our nose is a sensor. Okay. Our body is having a lot of sensors which sense the sensations, right? So sensors are basically doing sensing. You see, there are a few sensors which make contact with the physical mean and do the sensing operation. Agree or not? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
That is called as contact type of sensor. Like suppose we want to measure the level of a liquid. Suppose we are dipping a scale into that and then measuring the level, then it is called as a contact type of level measurement. Reverse is non-contact type. There are some sensor which makes the sensing operation even without making the contact. The significance of this is, like suppose the COVID-related parameter. What is the COVID-related parameter? Temperature, right? Yes, no? Are you on or off? What are the COVID-related parameters? Yeah, you are on. Please respond. Okay, respond to the question. What are the COVID related parameters? Temperature. Simplest one is temperature. Suppose you go into some area. Okay. Suppose you go into some area, okay, where they want to follow the COVID protocol. So what they will do is they have a gun, right? The help of which they do the measurement of temperature. So are they using a gun which is making physical contact with the person and measuring the temperature? Did you observe that? Temperature gun. Temperature measurement gun.
No physical contact, sir.
Yeah, no. देखो आप लोग लेट करेंगे तो मैं लेट करूंगा बोल दे रहा हूँ मैं. Immediately I want answer. There will be no physical contact, right? So that type of sensor is called as non-contact sensor, right? So hope this point is clear to everybody. Yes, no.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Next parameter is its temperature range is good, meaning it can work as per the design for lot of temperatures. That is called as good temperature, high stability. Okay, so it's very clear feature. Now I'm coming to long answer question. The principle of operation of capacitive transducer. It is based on this particular equation, well known, very familiar equation, right? C is equal to epsilon naught into epsilon r a divided by b. So I'm including both in k. So for air we know that it is equal to 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12. Its SI unit is farad per meter. Similarly, A is the area of the plates whose SI unit is meter square, and D is the distance between the two plates and whose unit is meter. SI unit is meter. So the value of capacitance C unit is farad, right? Hope it is clear to everybody.
Yes, sir.
Great. I will give you figures later, but for now, this is the distance between the two plates, and this is the area of the plate. So, area of the plate, and what is the medium in between the plate? Based upon that, K value will be calculated, right? Hope yes, it is clear to everybody. Now I'm coming to the point which we want to discuss. See, we are trying to sense some of the surrounding parameter in terms of change in capacitance. Agree or not?
Yes, sir.
We are finding or sensing surrounding parameter in terms of change in capacitance. But capacitance is dependent on three different variables, K, A, and D. So the principle of operation can be a function of any of these three parameters. The change in capacitance can be a function of change in dielectric. The change in capacitance can be a function of change in area. The change in capacitance can be a function of change in the distance between the two plates. So based upon that, we will be having three different ways of sensing surrounding parameter in terms of change in capacitance. So first one is in terms of K. We should prove that the change in capacitance with respect to its actual capacitance. Aise measurement ko kya bolte hain maloom hai? Kya bolenge? Relative measurement. Earlier also I told you. Kya bolenge isko? Relative measurement. The change in capacitance divided by total capacitance. If we are measuring like this, then this called as relative measurement. Is it clear to everybody? Relative.
Yes, sir.
Relative measurement is clear.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. In terms of dielectric, it will be written like this, delta K by K. In terms of area, it is written as delta A by A. In terms of distance between the two plates, it is written as minus delta d by d. What is the common in these three different measurements? What is the common thing? Can you please answer? What is the common thing? Okay, no problem. I will tell you. The common thing in all three is linearity. Did you agree with that?
Yes, sir.
Idhar dekho. Suppose if I make a plot, y-axis delta c by c, x-axis, what is the input? Delta k by k. In one case, second case, delta
symmetry
c by c,
a by a. Third case, delta
minus d by d.
Minus d by d. So I'm using different color to represent this thing. First, I'm using green color to indicate for delta k by k. This is for इसको डेल्टा के वाई के नहीं बोलेंगे, इसको क्या बोलेंगे बोला तो, दिस आई विल कॉल एज वेरिएबल डाइइलेक्ट्रिक कैपेसिटेंस ट्रांसड्यूसर. इज इट क्लियर? वेरिएबल डाइइलेक्ट्रिक कैपेसिटेंस ट्रांसड्यूसर. सो आई एम यूजिंग दिस ग्रीन कलर टू रिप्रेजेंट फॉर variable area capacitance transducer, and I'm using red color to represent variable distance capacitance transducer. बताइए, इज इट क्लियर टू यू? और दिस इज एक्चुअली द कंपैरेटिव ग्राफ बिटवीन डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कैपेसिटेंस ट्रांसड्यूसर एंड इट्स रिलेटिव मेजरमेंट. सो इन केस ऑफ वेरिएबल कैपेसिटेंस, सॉरी डाइइलेक्ट्रिक एंड वेरिएबल एरिया, वी आर गेटिंग linear relation with positive slope. And in case of variable distance capacitance transducer, again we are getting linear relation between change in capacitance and change in the parameter, but with negative slope. Agree or not?
Yes, sir.
पूरे छह के छह लोगों को समझ में आ रही है बात?
Yes, sir.
Great. Can I move further? हमको क्या करना है मालूम है? नेक्स्ट वी नीड टू प्रूव दैट दिस आइडेंटिटी, वी नीड टू प्रूव दिस आइडेंटिटी, वी नीड टू प्रूव दिस आइडेंटिटी एंड वी नीड टू प्रूव दिस आइडेंटिटी इन नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ टुडे सेशन. आर यू रेडी फॉर दैट?
यस सर.
ओके, फर्स्ट कंसीडर डेल्टा सी बाई सी इज इक्वल टू डेल्टा के बाई के. It's very simple. I want you to work with me at least for this derivation. So consider the formula for capacitance. It is equal to C A divided by D. In order to get for this particular case, what we need to do is we need to differentiate this equation with respect to what? Bolo, K A D. What?
D.
We need to differentiate with respect to K, because we are working on this. So delta c will be equal to a by d will take over here. So differentiation of delta k will be, the k will be delta k, right? 1 into delta k. Now divide this equation by c, dividing the above equation by c. So delta C by C will be equal to, here this side it is like this. So divided by C, C is equal to K A divided by D. So what happened? It become
delta K by K.
Right. So how simple this is? Okay. Easily we can do for the other two cases. Now prove that delta C by C is equal to delta K by K. चलिए करिए जल्दी से. What is this called?
Variable dielectric.
Variable area.
Area.
कैपेसिटेंस ट्रांसड्यूसर. तो क्या बोलेंगे? वेरिएबल डाइलेक्ट्रिक कैपेसिटेंस ट्रांसड्यूसर. एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड एज वेरिएबल एरिया कैपेसिटेंस ट्रांसड्यूसर. राइट? सो वी कैन इजीली प्रूव दिस थिंग इन सेम वे. ओके, हियर वी नीड टू डिफरेंशिएट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू व्हाट?
ए.
ग्रेट. सो डेल्टा सी वी कैन राइट एज के बाई डी इंटू डेल्टा ए. नाउ डिवाइड ऑन बोथ साइड. C, it does. Please try this step and tell me whether you are getting or not. Are you getting? Yes, no.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can I move further?
Yes, sir.
Okay. The last part of this question, we need to prove that delta C by C can be coming as delta D by D again, but with negative sign.
Variable parameter capacitor.
Variable D, distance capacitance transducer. Good. This will be called as VDCT. Variable distance capacitive transducer. So to prove this thing again, consider this equation and differentiate here with respect to what?
D.
Great. Differentiation of this will be correct. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now divide by C. So this give rise to minus delta D divided by D.
Yes, I got it.
What is the conclusion? What is the conclusion? The relative method of capacitance measurement is what? Boliye, answer. Linear. Yes, no?
Yes.
Is linear. Okay? That is the conclusion. Now, quickly after this, I am going to discuss a possible short answer question topic. Are you ready for that?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Disadvantage of capacitive transducer. Okay. Disadvantage of capacitive transducer. In order to discuss this particular problem, we need to first write the impedance of capacitors. अभी इधर देखें, I'm considering a body, I'm considering it to be what? Capacitive transducer, correct? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
So, we can model this as something like this, right? So, this is input, this is output. How much impedance a capacitor offer? Any idea? Which is called as reactance of a capacitance. You know that it is equal to
1 by omega.
J omega?
J omega C.
Correct? So,
yes, sir.
Yes.
If I try to take the magnitude, it will be
1 by omega C.
1 by omega C. Right? 1 by omega C. Great. So, the impedance of capacitance transducer keenly observed is a function of what? Two parameters. This is looking to be variable, and this can be a constant, no problem. This is the parameter which we want to measure, okay? Variable 1, variable 2. But this is wanted variable, agree or not?
Yes, sir.
But how about this? This is unwanted variable. This may create disturbance. I will prove this thing. What is omega? So can I write x?
2 pi f.
X is inversely proportional to omega?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I will write even that. 2 pi f. For simplicity, can I write like this? X is a function of f? Yes, no?
Yes, sir. Frequency.
Huh. Frequency. This can be low. This can be medium. And this can be
high.
High. So, if f is changing its phases with frequency, then obviously x will also be changing its phase with frequency. Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
Now I'm coming to very, very important discussion. आप लोग कई बार सुने होंगे noise, 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 right?
Yes, sir.
चलिए क्या है ये noise? कीले मकोड़े हैं क्या है ये?
Pixels.
नहीं देखिए मेरी बात सुनिए. This is a term which is used in different engineering subjects. It's nature get changes with subjects. Now the subject or the topic under discussion, with respect to that, if we are trying to define what is noise, is nothing but, it is nothing but unwanted signals, right? Usually this occurs at low and high frequencies. The noise amplitude, unki jo kad hoti na, the strength of signal is very, very less. But it is having different natures of low frequencies and high frequencies. So, in short, what I want to show you is, abhi idhar dekhiye, I'm coming to the topic. What is the behavior of XC for low frequency? If omega is equal to low, I'm considering it to be zero, right? So XC is equal to
infinity.
How much?
Infinity.
Infinity.
Infinity for low frequency. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. XC is equal to 1 by, I'm considering very high frequency. So 1 by infinity will be equal to how much?
Zero.
Zero.
For high frequency. You see, the reactance of capacitance or the impedance of our capacitance transducer is infinite for low frequency एंड जीरो फॉर हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी। जीरो का मतलब क्या होता है मालूम? खुशामदीद, वेलकम। इन्फिनाइट का मतलब क्या होता है मालूम? ब्लॉक। एग्री और नॉट? सो इट इज वेलकमिंग हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी सिग्नल विच इज यूजुअली ए नॉइस। सो कैपेसिटेंस ट्रांसड्यूसर आर एक्चुअली प्रोन टू नॉइस सिग्नल। यस नो?
यस सर।
So I will write a general point that conclusion. XC is showing different behaviors for different frequencies, right? This is called as, इसको क्या बोलते हैं मालूम है? इंपिडेंस मिसमैच। क्या बोलते हैं इसको? What is this problem called? Technical name of this problem, इंपिडेंस मिसमैच। समझ में आ रही बात? Is it clear to everybody?
Yes.
इंपिडेंस मिसमैच, ठीक है। नाउ सॉल्यूशन, कैसे सॉल्व करेंगे इसको? एनी आइडिया? हैव यू स्टडी एनालॉग इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स बिफोर दिस कोर्स? एनालॉग इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स, हाँ। हैव यू सीन एनी इंपिडेंस मैचिंग सर्किट्स?
नो सर।
You have seen, I know, I am telling you. Solution is use impedance matching circuit in between sensor and surrounding. Agree? What is that impedance matching circuit? Example, we can use वोल्टेज फॉलोअर सर्किट। याद आ रहा? वोल्टेज फॉलोअर सर्किट।
यस सर।
व्हाट इज वोल्टेज फॉलोअर सर्किट? इन विच, इन दिस केस आउटपुट वोल्टेज इज इक्वल टू इनपुट वोल्टेज। सो व्हाट फॉर वी यूज दिस थिंग? इट इज impedance matching circuit. Okay, बात समझ में आ गई?
Yes sir.
So let us go back and quickly recap. So I told you the possible disadvantage of capacitance transducer is its impedance behavior is looking to be different for different frequencies. So that give rise to different behavior to different frequency signals. So you know that problem is called as impedance mismatching. So in order to solve this problem, we can use a circuit in between sensor and surrounding, and that is called as impedance matching circuit. One of the possible example of impedance matching circuit is voltage follower circuit, in which output voltage follows the input, that is output voltage is equal to input voltage, but it provide impedance matching function. Is it clear to everybody? Can I move further?
Yes, sir.
Next, I am going to discuss one of the interesting application of capacitance transducer. सुभान मैगरी की कोई कौन कौन गए अब तक बताइए? Anybody visited Subhan Bakery?
Yes, sir.
What is this you observe in Subhan Bakery at the entrance?
Door.
Okay, everywhere door is there. What type of door available with that bakery?
Glass door.
Okay, everywhere glass doors are available. What type of glass door?
Sliding glass door.
Even
sensor detected.
Ha, that is the thing which I am interested in asking you from you, right? So example where this is located is Subhan Bakery. Subhan Bakery at entrance. This sensor is located at Subhan Bakery entrance. This sensor is located. Where else this sensor is located? Can you identify some more places at which this sensor is located?
Left.
Great.
Left.
Elevators.
Yes, sir.
Great. Aur bataiye.
Escalator.
Sink.
Escalators. Yeah. Not all. Ye apne.
Kamdu.
मेट्रो रेल है ना मेट्रो रेल
यस सर
यस सर
हाँ मेट्रो रेल एस्केलेटर
फासेट
क्या है वो व्हाट इज दैट
फासेट सर
व्हाट इज दैट फासेट आई डोंट नो चलिए इतने काफी है राइट दिस मच आर इनफ नाउ So this interesting sensor physically look like this. Physically look like this. It is having three wires. ये पहला वायर होता है VCC.
Basically like a fuse, sir.
It's not a fuse. मैं आऊँगा उसके ऊपर. Ground and output. Three wires, right? ये ऊपर नीचे भी हो सकते हैं. But it is having three wires. VCC, ground and output. ठीक है? मैं I'm going in reverse direction so that you will be getting interest and you will be making use of this when you want to make some project. That is what my intention is. So here in the surrounding, any object come in the area of this thing. What happens is I'm taking this out. This output is equal to no if no object. Agree? अब लो का मतलब जीरो वोल्ट बता दूंगा एंड दिस आउटपुट इज बताइए क्या होगा इफ देर इज एन ऑब्जेक्ट दैट इज नथिंग बट वी कैन ऑब्जर्व 5 वोल्ट At the output, if there is an object in the area, correct? Is it clear to everybody? Yes, no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
This is our sensor. So I'm considering the behavior of this output by a pin. This output pin give low. Output are 0 volts if there is no object in the nearby area, and this output give high information, logic high, or 5 volts if there is an object in the nearby area. Is it clear to everybody? Yes, no. Are
they? Yes, sir.
So this type of sensor which give information either yes or no, low can be called as no, low can be called as no, and high can also be called as yes.
Yes.
The sensor which give two possible output, high or low, is called as डिजिटल सेंसर क्या बोलेंगे इसको प्लीज रिपीट
डिजिटल सेंसर
डिजिटल सेंसर हर बच्चा दोहरा है उसको क्योंकि दुनिया वाले सब आपको ये पूछेंगे The fundamental question everybody going to ask you is this. Can you differentiate between digital sensor and analog sensor? If you define in this way, then you will be valued. Remember, I promise. Tell you, Dhara also. What is out? What is digital sensor? A sensor which gives two possible output is called as digital sensor. Please repeat with me. I request you to repeat with me. What is digital sensor? A sensor which gives two possible outputs is called as digital sensor. Please boliye mere sath ek baar.
A sensor which gives both two possible outputs.
Ha. It's called as digital sensor. So, now I'm asking a reverse question. What is analog sensor then? What is analog sensor?
A sensor which has only one outcome?
No. A sensor which has many outputs at least more than two ideally infinite is it clear
yes sir
is called as analog sensor you will understand this thing when you study this thing you will understand this thing But for now, please remember the meaning of digital sensor and analog sensor in this way. Just observe how many output your sensor is giving. If it is giving only two possible output, it is digital sensor. If it is giving many possible outputs, then it is what? What?
Analog sensor.
Analog sensors. Okay? I sincerely request you not to forget this part. चलिए, now I am coming to proximity sensor. Please observe this. This is our proximity sensor. So, the top view of this sensor is like this. Okay? And internally, this sensor is having First part as a capacitor, second part as an oscillator, third part as sine wave to square wave converter, and last part is some signal conditioning circuit with the help of which we can take the output out. So I will explain you this thing. Can I include this in our white chart?
Yes, sir.
एक सेकंड है क्या करूं फिर मैं इसको चलिए छोटा हो गया। Is it okay now?
Yes, sir.
Now, this is nothing but our proximity sensor. बहुत सिंपल है ये, इंशाल्लाह अच्छी तरह समझ जाएंगे आप लोग प्रॉक्सिमिटी सेंसर। थोड़ा गौर से सुनिए, प्लीज लिसन केयरफुली। जस्ट नाउ आई टोल्ड यू द बिहेवियर ऑफ दिस प्रॉक्सिमिटी सेंसर इज लाइक दिस। इफ इट ऑब्जर्व an object in the area, it give high voltage. If it don't observe object in the nearby area, it give low voltage. ठीक है? I think that is clear to everybody. Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
हाँ, एक बात तो clear है इधर. Output is equal to either 0 volt or 5 volt. When we can observe 0 volt, no object in the area. When we can observe 5 volt, if there is an object in the area. Okay, isse pehle what are the thing internally this circuit is having and what are the principles on which this is based. Chaliye, I'm putting one question on you. Can we charge a non-metal? Yes, no? A non-metallic object will be charged or not? Like plastic, rubber or something like that? Your cloth?
No.
Yes. क्या पढ़े यार physics? ठीक है? As per Faraday's law of electromagnetism, Faraday's law of what is that? There is one law, no? If we rub some object, then charges will form on that. Coulomb's law, right? As per Coulomb's law, the charge can form on any object, irrespective of its nature, metal or non-metal. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
हाँ, that's why this type of transducer is suitable for both metallic and non-metallic object. Exam mein question aata, is capacitance transducer is suitable for metallic or non-metallic object? Justify. First part क्या बोलेंगे? It is suitable for metallic as well as non-metallic object detection. Justification में क्या लिखेंगे? As any object can charge, right? Is it clear to everybody?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. मैं बोल रहा हूँ, वो इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चन है, आता वाई capacitance transducer, sorry, Y proximity, Y proximity sensor made with capacitance principle. Is suitable for both conductive and non-conductive object. Answer क्या लिखेंगे? Answer is simple, as charge can be accumulated on any object. बस यही आंसर है. That's why capacitance transducer is suitable for both conductive and non-conductive object. ठीक है, इज इट क्लियर टू एवरीबॉडी?
यस सर.
आई एम गोइंग टू नेक्स्ट पेज. देयर आल्सो आई एम इंसर्टिंग वन इमेज दैट इज प्रॉक्सिमिटी सेंसर. नाउ आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ ऑपरेशन. गौर से सुनो. यू सी, अब इधर क्या होता मालूम है? प्लीज लिसन केयरफुली. बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमान. वी ऑल नो दैट कैपेसिटेंस ट्रांसड्यूसर इज हैविंग टू प्लेट्स. यस नो? यस नो?
यस सर.
हाँ, इन केस ऑफ प्रॉक्सिमिटी सेंसर वन ऑफ द प्लेट इज a part of internal circuit and another plate is object. ठीक है, another plate is object. So both together are behaving like a capacitor. Internally we have inducting circuit and both are powered by a power supply, right? If this setup is called as oscillator, this setup is called as what? Oscillator. Which oscillator? LC oscillator. This setup is called as LC oscillator. Have you heard about LC oscillator?
Yes sir, NRI electronics.
What is the function of LC oscillator? Main bataunga kya karta hai LC oscillator. LC oscillator take no input but give sine output. Yes, no? बोलिए बाबा. यस नो? यस. अब इसको क्या होना है मालूम है? ऑलरेडी 5 वोल्ट्स आर अवेलेबल, ऑलरेडी एल इज अवेलेबल, बट वी नीड टू मेक सी. सो हाउ कैन वी मेक सी? वन प्लेट ऑफ सर्किट इज अवेलेबल, अनदर प्लेट इज मिसिंग. इफ दैट प्लेट कम इन द एरिया, इफ दैट प्लेट कम इन द एरिया, इट गेट चार्ज बिकॉज ऑफ दिस सप्लाई एंड इट बिकम ए सी. And our LC oscillator circuit started giving sinusoidal output. This is the fundamental function or principle of proximity sensor. Okay? Is it clear to everybody?
Yes, sir.
चलिए यहाँ लिखिए आप. LC oscillator. LC oscillator give sine output if form when C form indirect. Answer is if object is in the area of electric field. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next point. We have a trigger circuit. Trigger circuit. Trigger circuit is nothing but Schmitt trigger. Schmitt trigger padhe aap log?
No, analog sir.
Electronics mein Schmitt trigger padhe?
No, sir.
No problem. Bilkul, koi problem nahi baat. Schmitt trigger kya kaam karta bata deta hu main aapko. Schmitt trigger take साइन इनपुट ऐसे दिखेगा ना साइन
सर
एंड कन्वर्ट इट इनटू स्क्वायर वेव बस इतना याद रखो इज इनफ Schmitt trigger टेक साइन इनपुट एंड गिव विच आउटपुट
स्क्वायर
स्क्वायर ठीक है स्क्वायर आउटपुट दैट्स व्हाई यू सी LC circuit is giving sinusoidal signal if object is in the area. Trigger circuit convert this sine signal into a square wave if object is in the area. So this square wave, ये जो square wave है ना आप लोग थोड़ा confused हो जाएंगे. मैं इसको क्या करता हूँ मालूम है? एक word add कर दे. This square wave is not having negative part. This is 0 volts and this is 5 volts. So 0 volt is observed if there is no sign. 5 volt is observed if there is a sinusoidal signal. Hope it is clear to everybody.
Yes, sir.
Okay, you want to make some points on this?
Yes, sir.
Please write down. Ready?
Yes, sir.
Now, first point, write down. First point, write down. In this setup, the sensor in bracket write on object. In this setup, the sensor in bracket write on object is playing the role of one of the plate of capacitor. Is playing the role of one of the plate of capacitor. Come and continue. The other plate is available internally in the circuit. The other plate is available in the circuit internally. Can I move further?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, next point right now. Next point right now. Proximity sensor consisting of two important parts. Proximity sensor consisting of two important parts. One is LC oscillator. Another one, trigger circuit. Dekho, proximity sensor consisting of two important parts. First part is what? LC oscillator. सेकेंड पार्ट इज व्हाट ट्रिगर सर्किट.
ट्रिगर सर्किट
अभी इधर देखिए ये जो फिगर है ना ये फिगर में वजाहत से बताया जा रहा. दिस इज सी एंड इंटरनली एल इज अवेलेबल. इंटरनली अभी इधर देखो ये जो बी है ना बी इज द ऑब्जेक्ट यूजर. ए इज द एरिया. ये जो बी और एक प्लेट है ना इट इज इंटरनली अवेलेबल. वन प्लेट इज द सेंसर. अनदर प्लेट इज ऑलरेडी अवेलेबल. And A is the area. C is sorry, L inductor is already available. Together is forming LC circuit. So this LC circuit, ये point लिखना है next. LC circuit, next point write down. LC circuit give sine output. LC circuit give sine output. If C is formed, इसका मतलब क्या है मालूम है? ये जो प्लेट है ना, ये ऑलरेडी ऑलवेज फिक्स नहीं है, ये वर्चुअल है. जब आदमी आ रहा है या फिर कोई ऑब्जेक्ट आ रहा है, देन ओनली दिस प्लेट इज बिकमिंग फिजिकल, अदरवाइज इट इज ओनली अजम्पशन. ओके, सी इज फॉर्म. ठीक है, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सी? You can write this in bracket. If object is in the area of electric field, that is nothing but formation. That is nothing but the meaning of formation of C. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So, क्या हो गया हमको ये समझ में आ गया? So, we got to know that when a person come in the area, L is getting formed. Sorry, C is getting formed, and our oscillator circuit is started giving. Sine signal, right? Started giving sine signal, but it is very difficult to measure sinusoidal signal. I am raising this question. Did you agree with me? अब एक सवाल आता, why are we not measuring sine signal? Answer is, it is very difficult to measure sinusoidal signal. That's why. To have or to perform convenient measurement of our proximity sensor output, we are inserting a trigger circuit which converts sine signal into square wave. Chalo, next point likho. As it is difficult to measure sine signal, ya phir bracket mein likho, it is costly measurement. Sine measurement is what? Costly measurement. Agree or not? बाद में समझ में आता.
यस सर.
या एज इट इज क्या बोल क्या लिखा है हमें, इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू मेजर साइनसोइडल सिग्नल कॉमा एंड कंटिन्यू, हेंस वी आर एडिंग, हेंस वी आर एडिंग ए ट्रिगर सर्किट, हेंस वी आर एडिंग ए ट्रिगर सर्किट, ब्रैकेट में लिखो श्मिट ट्रिगर, हेंस वी आर एडिंग ए ट्रिगर सर्किट, इन ब्रैकेट राइट ऑन श्मिट ट्रिगर. Which convert sinusoidal signal into square wave. Bracket में लिखो unsymmetrical. In bracket write down unsymmetrical. मैं बताता हूँ किसको बोलते हैं. हाँ, we are using trigger circuit, in bracket Schmitt trigger. Convert sine signal into square wave. ये cosine square wave है. Which type of square wave it is?
Positive.
नहीं जी बाबा,
unsymmetrical.
Right? Hope it is clear to everybody.
Yes, sir.
So that's all from today's session. Sorry, I have taken extra time, but I'm helpless. I need to cover more in less time. Okay, hope you enjoyed today's class.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, give your attendance quickly. Okay, answer your attendance. बोलिए
सर. आई विल से द नंबर्स.
या आई जस्ट मेक द रिकॉर्डिंग ऑफ.